read the manual. That's what the Linux veterans advise. But reading the manual pages is often boring or complicated. This is why there exist different tools that, dare I say, are better than man pages. Okay, maybe not better than man pages, but surely easier to navigate and understand. And in this video, I'll show some of those man page-like tools that you can use to know how to use a Linux command directly in your terminal. Qman provides a modern interface to the classic man pages. It adds features like hyperlinks, web browser-like navigation, a table of content for each page, incremental search, online help, and much more. By default, it shows an index page that displays all the manual pages available on the system, sorted alphabetically and organized by sections. You can enter a section, scroll through the commands, and then press the home key to go back up at the top. You don't have to scroll through all the commands. That would be boring and stupid. You can search the command you are looking for. Enter the desired command and you will notice a table of content at the top. You can jump to any section from here. You'll also notice that mentioned commands here are hyperlinked. You can use it to switch it to the man pages of the linked commands. Switch too many commands? Press backspace to go back or display the navigation history with Shift-S and then jump to the desired page. You can also use apropos to search for the commands that match your given string in the description of the commands and then go to the desired command. You can also change Qman config and give it a different theme if that's your thing. The option is there to explore. If you were born after the 90s, you're likely to be in the too long didn't read situation with the extensive manual pages. The TLDR project simplifies this by giving simple examples of the commands instead, because that's what you're looking for most of the time. I prefer the Rust implementation of TLDR actually, because it is faster than the original TLDR project. When you run TLDR for the first time, you need to update the cache first. And then when you have to look for the reference on how to use a command, you just use the TLDR followed by the command name. And you can see that it shows command users with examples. These are easier to understand, don't you think so? You know what else is easier? Self-hosting open source software with pickup ports. No need to configure all those Docker Compose files. Just look for your favorite open source software and deploy it in seconds. You can configure the server's resources before or even after deployment. And you can have backups enabled and a lot more. You can try it for free with the $5 welcome credit. Link is in the description. Next up is Navi. It is an interactive cheat sheet tool. Basically, here you have a collection of one-liner commands contributed by the community. You can browse through them and use it in your scenario. You can look for various cheat sheets or examples available on a command. Read their description and see if it is something you can use. And all this is interactive. Let me give you an example. Let's say I want to archive this text file with tar. I look for examples matching the string tar in Navi and find the example that fits my case. I select that and the example is interactive as it asks me to provide the option and then runs the given tar command. And as you can see, the tar archive file is now created. Let me delete the text file so that I have only the tar file in the current directory. Now I want to extract it. I look for the extract option and this time it didn't even ask for the file name and extracted it because there was only one tar file in the directory. That's smart, you know. If your focus is only on cheat sheets and get the best of community-driven inputs for the same, cheat.sh is the perfect terminal tool for you. Installation is optional as you can use curl to fetch the cheat sheet on the command of your choice directly in the terminal. Although, you can install it for offline reference and switch to its command line interface and look for cheat sheets on various Linux commands. Cheatsheet also has cheat sheets for Python, Go, Perl, Rust, and many other programming languages. What else can you ask for? Alright, this is not a new man page tool. However, you can add some colors to the otherwise plain looking manual pages. By default, Qman uses less as the pager tool. You can change the bash config to use most as the pager. It will add colors, which makes reading the classic Qman page a bit easier to read and follow. Before I end this video, let me share another quick tip. If you are using Gnome, you can launch Qman pages from the Firefox web browser. It uses Gnome's built-in help tool Yelp for this function. I'm sure there are a few more tools out there that do the same job. Terminals like WAP have built-in AI agent to help you with the commands. While Qman page still remains the ultimate reference documentation, these additional tools ease the complexity of the legacy manuals. Link to all the mentioned tools are in the description. I let them explore you, and I'll see you in another video. Stay subscribed. Keep on Linuxing. Bye-bye.